Hi, I am Linda. In this video, I shall explore the meaning of Heberden's nodes and why they develop if you have osteoarthritis. A Heberden's node is a bony lump found on the finger joints closest to the tips and is called the distal interphalangeal joint. I shall also explore the understanding of Heberden's nodes, the treatments, and much more, but first I shall go into a brief explanation of what is osteoarthritis. When you develop osteoarthritis, it attacks your complete joints, which include your cartilage, bone, synovium, and soft tissue surrounding the affected joint, and progressively ruins the articular cartilage, that is the smooth tissue which covers the ends of the bones where the two bones make the joints. This can lead to, number 1, the cartilage being eroded. When the cartilage wears down, it eventually exposes the underlying bone, which gets damaged over time. At this stage, you will be able to hear cracking and creaking sounds when you move. Number 2, osteophyte formation, which is where the body attempts to repair the damage. It is done by creating new bone, which leads to osteophytes, or bone spurs. These bone spurs are a type of Heberden's nodes that form on the distal interphalangeal or fingers. Number 3, the space between the bones and the joints becomes narrow. This is where the cartilage is wearing away, leading to symptoms of stiffness and pain. And number 4 is the inflammation of the synovium. It is the lining of the joints that becomes inflamed, which leads to further worsening of the symptoms and therefore more pain. The Heberden's nodes mainly develop as a hard bony lump on the finger joints. They mainly appear on both hands and can vary in size. This means that if you develop one on your left middle finger, you will probably get one on your right middle finger. These nodes are normally associated with pain and tenderness, especially if your job is typing all day and you are putting pressure on the affected joints. Number 2 is stiffness. This is often worse in the morning or after a time of not doing any activity. Number 3 is reduced range of motion. This is due to the changes in the finger. There is a visible deformity of the fingers affected, and can be distressing for you. The diagnosis of Heberden's nodes involves imaging studies. Physicians will look for any bony enlargements of the finger joints and assess the pain and the impairment. X-rays can also see for any osteophytes and if there are narrowing of the joint space. There are some risk factors when you develop Heberden's nodes, which can include, number 1, genetics. Studies have shown that if you have a family history of osteoarthritis, you are more likely to develop the condition. Number 2 is your age and gender. When you become over the age of 50, you are more likely to develop osteoarthritis, as it is a disease that is called wear and tear of the joints. Also, if you are a woman listening to this, you are at risk after your menopause. If your work involves repetitive use of your hands and fingers, such as manual labor, or you have a certain hobby, it can lead to mechanical stress on the joints, making osteoarthritis and Heberden's nodes worse. A previous joint injury or fracture in the fingers can also contribute to the development. When you develop this terrible disease, it is best if you focus on alleviating the symptoms of Heberden's nodes, so that you can improve the joint function and help prevent further joint damage. The treatment strategies can be categorized into 3 parts. Part 1 is non-pharmacological approaches, which can include, number 1, lifestyle modification, which can be exercises. These are low-impact exercises like swimming, walking, and stretching. These can help to keep your joints mobile and reduce stiffness. Maintaining a healthy weight. If you are overweight, you should eat healthier, as it will reduce the stress on the joints and slow the progression of osteoarthritis down. Another one is if you work, you should ask if you could modify your workstations and use assistive devices that can minimize strain on your fingers during your daily tasks. Number 2 is physical therapy, which has 2 parts. One is therapeutic exercises. Physical therapy can give you an exercise program that is designed to your specific needs to improve your strength and flexibility in the hands and fingers. And part 2 is manual therapy. This technique can include massaging your fingers, which can help reduce the pain and improve the function of your fingers. Number 3 is in 2 parts also. The first is occupational therapy, which is adaptive techniques which can teach you to perform daily tasks more efficiently, with less pain. Splinting is another. This can help support the affected joints, reducing the pain and preventing further deformity. Number 4 is heat and cold therapy. Heat therapy is applied to pain, which can help relax muscles and reduce the pain in the joints. Cold therapy reduces inflammation and numbs the sore areas. But with cold or ice packs, you must always wrap the pack in a towel and never put the pack on your skin. Part 2 Pharmacological treatments can be in 4 parts. Number 1 is analgesics. This can include acetaminophen, which is often recommended for the beginning treatment for mild to moderate pain. Or you could be prescribed non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs that include ibuprofen and naproxen. These can reduce both pain and inflammation. Number 2 is topical treatments. These also include non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, such as creams or gels, applied directly to the affected joints for localized pain relief. Or capsaicin cream, which is from chili peppers, and proven pain relief by reducing substance P, which is a chemical involved in transmitting pain signals. Number 3 is corticosteroid injections, which are injections that go between the affected joints. This can help substantially with your pain, and it can reduce the inflammation, but the effects are normally temporary. I have had this done twice a year, but eventually, it did nothing for me, as I have arthritis in the spine. Number 4, disease-modifying osteoarthritis drugs, or emerging therapies. Research is an ongoing development of drugs that slows the progression of osteoarthritis. Part 3, surgical interventions are considered when other treatments fail to give adequate relief, and your quality of life is stuck with pain and inflammation that will get worse. There are 2 parts to this. Number 1 is joint fusion or arthrodesis, which is a procedure that involves fusing the joint bones of the affected joints. This stops movement and therefore pain. Or if you have severe pain and instability in the finger joints that do not react to other treatments. The second is joint replacement or arthroplasty, which is a procedure that replaces the damaged joint with an artificial implant. However, it is less common for your finger joints due to their small size and complex surgery. There is ongoing research into new treatments for Heberden's nodes and osteoarthritis. Some of them include, number 1 biologic therapies, which can be platelet-rich plasma that involves injection of a concentration of your platelets to help healing and reduce inflammation. There is evidence into this that suggests that it can provide pain relief and improve your function of osteoarthritis. Another biologic therapy could be stemming cell therapy, which uses stem cells to renew damaged joint tissues. Evidence of this shows potential, but more studies need to be done to confirm efficacy and safety. There are many supplements on the market today, but 2 of the best supplements to help with osteoarthritis are number 1. Glucosamine and chondroitin. These supplements are believed to support cartilage health and reduce the symptoms of osteoarthritis. The evidence for this has mixed results from studies. The second supplement is omega-3 fatty acids, which are full of anti-inflammatory properties that help reduce osteoarthritis. There is some evidence that supports their use in reducing pain and joint function. But if you want to take supplements, you should see your doctor or healthcare professional before taking any supplements, as some can interfere with your medication. You can prevent the development of Heberden's nodes and osteoarthritis and prevent early symptoms by doing regular exercises that help with strengthening your muscles. These could be aerobics or low-impact exercises each week. Number 2 is the most important one, which is having a balanced diet. You should focus on rich fruit and vegetables, whole grains, lean protein, and healthy fats, such as cooking in virgin olive oil. These help to maintain a healthy weight. And number 3, you should avoid injuring your joints, such as falling or lifting heavy objects the correct way using your muscle legs, taking regular breaks if you are sitting for a long time, or doing repetitive work. The conclusion is that unfortunately, when you develop osteoarthritis, you may develop Heberden's nodes, which are little lumps that appear on the ends of your finger. which can be challenging for you, as it can significantly affect the function of your hands. However, you can manage this with medical treatments and keep your hands moving, so that they do not get worse. When it is necessary, there are surgical interventions that can reduce the symptoms. By understanding Heberden's nodes and osteoarthritis, you can take steps to manage your condition. Ongoing research is promising for future treatments that can enhance your quality of life. Thanks for listening to my video. I am not a medical professional, and the information in this video is for information only. If you have any worries about your condition, you should consult with your healthcare professional. If you found this video helpful, then please click the subscribe button to follow my channel and press the bell. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below and I will get back to you. I hope this video has helped and good luck.